Good evening. The cost of living crisis that's hurting so many Australians is coming to an end with a welcome plunge in inflation. It dropped to 4.1% in December, the best result in 2 years. Good news for those with a mortgage. Economists expect no more rate hikes, only rate cuts, and soon.
Hoping the worst is now in the rearview mirror, but knowing there's a delicate balancing act ahead.
This is not mission accomplished, but it's really welcome.
Inflation diving to a two-year low in the December quarter, 4.1% annually, the monthly rate 3.4, just above the RBA's target range of between 2 and 3. Economists now predicting interest rate cuts could be just months away.
I reckon by the middle of the year, we will start to see interest rates and hence mortgage rates starting to fall.
Probably May, June, I would say. April might be a little bit optimistic.
And as many as three cuts this year. Good news for mortgage holders.
That would be awesome. I'd be able to save again, which is nice.
Interest on my rental investment would be less, which means I'm, I guess, making more money out of my investment property.
The biggest price drops in furniture, clothing and footwear, childcare fees down, wholesale electricity falling, but tobacco and travel both up.
The government claims its cost of living support is starting to help bring prices down and that its revamped tax cuts will soon put even more money in workers' pockets.
Inflation is slowing, real wages is growing, and from the 1st of July we will see tax cuts flowing.
Well, you know, we've seen a collapse in living standards and there's no sign of a reversal of that collapse in living standards.
Although inflation now has a 3 in front of it in Melbourne and Perth, Sydney and Brisbane 4.2, Adelaide the highest 4.8, an international trend.
Inflation is falling faster than anticipated in most regions.
But still needs to fall further.
Let's go live now to Mark Riley in Canberra. Mark, is this a real sign we're finally moving in the right direction?
Well, Mark, there's certainly some hope tonight that it is. This is a much steeper fall than the markets and the Reserve Bank expected, and there's now virtually no chance of the RBA increasing interest rates next week, and a good chance that the cycle of rises is now over. The one downside, I guess, is the possibility that unemployment will rise slightly, but only in the short term. The stock market certainly enjoyed today's inflation nosedive. It shot up to another record high. So all the signs from the data are good, but there are still some challenges ahead, Mark.
Mark Riley in Parliament House.